The Cold War may be over, but a nuclear apocalypse might be just around the corner. Thankfully, there are survival options. You're probably wondering why you're standing in front of a huge hill in the middle of a Kansas field. All will be revealed when we head 174 feet below the surface. You're about to take a tour of one of the most luxurious underground bunkers in the world. This underground doomsday shelter was once a Cold War era Atlas F missile silo, but now it's a luxury condo complex that's filled with amenities. There's a control room, medical room, activity area, and even a farm. Let's head inside the $153 million doomsday condo complex. The Survival Condo Company spent $20 million converting this missile silo into a luxury condo complex. It doesn't look much like more than a hill from the outside, but there's a massive monolithic dome under all that dirt. If you look to the left of the entrance, you'll see a large wind turbine that powers the complex. The entire structure is surrounded by an electric fence, and if you look to your right, you'll notice the weather tower. See these cameras? They send a direct feed of the bunker surroundings to the security room. Let's head through the blast-proof steel doors into the 20,000-square-foot dome. This is the top level of the Doomsday Condo Complex. It's above ground, but still incredibly safe. You're surrounded by $5 million worth of epoxy-hardened concrete walls and steel. Even a 500-mile-an-hour F5 tornado can't destroy this dome. The doors on your left lead to a full-size pool with a water slide, and the doors to your right lead to a parking garage which houses two $50,000 military-grade security vehicles. Let's take the high-speed elevator one level down. This is the bunker's first underground level. The concrete walls surrounding the next three levels are 9 feet thick. Let's head into that room and look at the bunker's control room. This is the $2 million central console where security officials monitor the bunker's exterior. Remember those cameras? Every angle is covered. Over there, you'll see the safety team hard at work. They monitor the smoke control system. If one of the condos catches fire, they can redirect smoke through the bunker's air filtration system. The team will warn you if there's a biological or chemical attack, and they also keep track of weather patterns. Let's head down the hall into the power room. You'll notice battery banks and diesel generators. The bunker has multiple power sources, so you'll never be left in the dark. Let's take the elevator down to the next level. This floor is the medical and security level. Let's head through those doors to your right and look inside the medical bay. That's the pharmacy where you'll find $3 million worth of emergency medical supplies and medicines. There's enough medicine here to last each resident 7 years. Let's continue through the medical bay into the operating room. Doctors perform minor surgeries here, and in the next room over, you'll find the dental clinic. The medical bay also has 3 examination rooms where residents can visit with physicians. Let's head to the west side of this level into the security area. This is the emergency supply room where survivalist equipment is stored. You'll see that the shelves and racks are filled with helmets and camo gear. Let's head through those doors into the armory. The security team has a wide array of weapons, and the firing range in the next room over can be used by residents too. Let's head back to the central elevator and down to the next level. On this level, you'll find the general store and farm. This is where you'll get your fresh produce. There's also $5 million worth of freeze-dried food stored here. Let's head through that tunnel to take a peek at the aquaculture system and hydroponic garden. Over there, you'll see some residents harvesting cabbage, and over there, you'll see residents feeding the tilapia. Let's head back to the central elevator and continue the tour. The next 7 levels are all condo units. There are penthouses, full units, and half units available. Each entry from this point on is encompassed by concrete walls that are 2.5 feet thick. Let's take a look at a penthouse. If you want to own a 3,600 square foot penthouse, you'll have to fork over $4.5 million. Don't worry about losing your key. Each condo is equipped with a biometric keyless entry system. Every unit has a washer, dryer, full spectrum LED lighting, stainless steel appliances, Kohler fixtures, and a 50-inch TV. The high-tech screens on the walls act as windows and offer a live feed of the above-ground exterior. You might even forget you're underground. If this penthouse is too pricey, you can opt for an 1,800-square-foot condo at a price of $3 million or 900-square-feet condo at a price of $1.5 million. Let's head back to the elevator and all the way down to the education level. This level is where you'll find the classroom and library. Let's head west and look at the library first. Those shelves are lined with $15,000 worth of books, and in the center of the room, you'll see comfortable chairs where you can catch up on your reading. If we head east, we'll arrive at the classroom. It's filled with state-of-the-art computers, and cubicles are lined up around the circumference of the classroom. Let's head back to the elevator and down to the activity level. Let's head east and look at the gym and spa. The gym is filled with $40,000 worth of workout equipment. You might not be able to run around outside, but the treadmill will do. Over on the west side of this level, you'll find the rock climbing wall and dog park. Yes, pets are allowed. Let's head down to the next level. This is the entertainment level. Those doors lead to a lounge area and arcade, and if we walk over to the east side of the level, we'll arrive at the cinema. There are 2,000 films stored in the bunker's database, so you'll never be bored down here. Let's head down to the final level. This level is both a storage area and pump room. Spare equipment and tools are stored down here, and those tanks are filled with clean drinking water that can be circulated through the entire facility. Before the Atlas F missile silo was converted into a luxury condo complex, it housed an intercontinental ballistic missile. Do you know that the U.S. government spent $8 billion building Atlas ICBMs between 1959 and 1966? That's it, folks. Thanks for watching.